for many of us, part of our identity has been taken by this situation. We know ourselves partly by what we do or our work. And some of us have gone from really productive, employed people to people that watch Netflix all day on the couch and don't have a paycheck anymore. It's easy to allow those things to affect what we think about ourselves. For those of us who are parents, it's not easy to be a parent, but it's easier when you have teachers and daycare professionals and grandparents and aunts and uncles who are helping. And for some of us now, we're with our kids all day long and we feel these questions like, am I really a good mom? Am I really a good dad? That accusing voice in our head is kind of rising up to say, you're not good enough. You're worthless. What are you providing for society? What are you producing? How, when you're home, what good are you to anyone? And those feelings of insecurity, those feelings of worthlessness can start to fill our minds and our hearts. Jesus experienced some of this on the cross in that as he goes through this process, his worth is constantly valued. People say, you thought that you were the Son of God, but you're just a bum. You're just a liar. You're just a blasphemer. And that sense of identity is greatly challenged by the situation that Jesus is put into.
The chief priests and the whole Sanhedrin were looking for false evidence against Jesus so that they could put him to death. But they did not find any, though many false witnesses came forward. Finally, two came forward and declared, "This fellow said, 'I am able to destroy the temple of God and rebuild it in 3 days.'" Then the high priest stood up and said to Jesus, "Are you not going to answer? What is this testimony that these men are bringing against you?" But Jesus remained silent. The high priest said to him, "I charge you under oath by the living God, tell us if you are the Messiah, the Son of God." "You've said so," Jesus replied. "But I say to all of you, from now on you will see the Son of Man sitting at the right hand of the Mighty One and coming on the clouds of heaven." Then the high priest tore his clothes and said, "He has spoken blasphemy. Why do we need any more witnesses? Look now, you have heard the blasphemy. What do you think?" "He is worthy of death," they answered.
Sometimes insecurity can interrupt our lives. Take a moment to kind of inventory your own insecurities, the places where you feel like you're not worthy or you're not valuable. Jesus, throughout Good Friday, suffers all sorts of attacks on who he is and if he's valuable and if he's worthy and if he is who he said he is. And he suffered all of that so that you could take your identity and root it in the perfect love of God.